£99 a month. So this gap is humongous. The case was won by the workers to have a minimum wage set, but that was never implemented. And this is the problem in Egypt. Even if you go through the reform way and the gradual and the legal way, you're bound to pay because, after all, this is not in the interest of the ruling party, the business elite, and those men. So right before January 25th, there was a lot of things happening. So we started with the election, Khalifa Ali, the elections, and then you have this attack on churches. This permit for a church in Al-Qaeda was rejected to be built. And there was an uprising, 9 people died, the clashes with police, 187 were arrested, and that was in December. And then you got in January, the beginning of the year, we had the Alexandria church bombing. So it was just boiling on a really sensitive issue, and the regime used this divide and rule mechanism when it comes to the Christian and Muslim sectarian divide, really. That doesn't exist between the people, and that the only the regime highlights and keeps on making even more uncomfortable for people in the street. And then you got Tunisia. Thank you for Tunisia. Because without Tunisia, they definitely set the process. I mean, it was heading to the revolution, but maybe you could have taken some longer time if Tunisia hadn't happened. But what Tunisia did is that it made the average people that didn't necessarily believe in the revolution, which were very few, to believe in the process of change through the power of the people, through revolution, through the streets. Because Tunisia, an Arab country, a dictator of, you know, very much similar to Mubarak, and they were capable, by the power of the people, to stop that, to take the dictator out. And we started mobilizing and organizing as an opposition with all the youth movements and the organized left. We started planning on, okay, we have this police day, it's a holiday, the January 25th, ironically. And we're going to call for mass demonstrations, not knowing that it would turn into a revolution. But if you were watching closely what happened in Egypt between January 14th and January 25th, you would see that we had five people died by setting themselves on fire. They wanted to be on Egypt. They wanted to start and trigger the revolution. They just didn't know how. But they wanted the revolution. They wanted what the Tunisians had and what the Tunisians did, even to the extent of replicating the trigger that what happened in Tunisia, that obviously, you know, it didn't necessarily work until the January 25th mass demonstration that we organized to start from urban poor areas, chanting socioeconomic chants that have to do with bread prices of meat, how the half a meter of Madinsi, which is a very wealthy gated community, sold for millions of pounds, was sold to this guy who went out and saw for half a pound, a meter. And the kilo of meat is £100. So how do you, so these were the chants that got people to come out of this house, their houses, and join in these mass demonstrations from the urban poor areas. And we were like, well, if we just reach Dahlia, that would be great. You know, that was the hope, to reach Dahlia. What would we do when we get to Dahlia? Well, we'll figure that out there. Because we had fought so many times for protests in Dahlia that never took place, because it was either closed off or people got arrested before we even get there. And that was the thing, and it worked great. I was in Shubra, and we started maybe like 500 people. By the time we marched around the area, we were 10,000 people starting to head to Tahrir. I went to Tahrir, Tahrir was already won, which was the most amazing sight to see. I couldn't stop crying all the time. I couldn't believe myself. I'm used to all these protests of the same 100 people. 200 people that go to every single protest. I mean, it's the same people, not every single protest. And to see the masses to actually take to the streets. And they were chanting, "Shout, you need to stop in the wrong," just like the Canadians. This was not in our plan. I mean, we were like, we're just going to get a mass demonstration, and let's hope for the best. And what is actually